Kahit po tayo mga kababayan, panangalian. Yan po. Adobong kangkong naman ngayon. Tapos ano nga ang tawag dito? Crispy pata po. Ayan. Ito yung adobong kangkong. At siyempre, banana. Ayan. Pinapachap-chap na namin kasi mahirap yung pag-chap-chap. Merry Christmas na po sa amin. Nanananghalian kami habang nakikinig tayo ng committee hearing, yung investigation po ng committee on ano, yung second public hearing po ng ano, good government and public accountability.
Baka mayroon po kayong copy ng sulat na yon. At kung
ginigisa po yung commission on audit,
baka pwede maibigay na po nila ngayon yung sulat.
At walang ano?
Sino pong representative?
Walang ni isa po sa Office of the Vice President ang dumating.
Shock yung ating mga congressmen kasi yung 35 million na parte ng confidential funds po ni Inday, 125 million. Ginastos lang po in 11 days.
Your Honor, may I be recognized, Your Honor?
Yes, ComSec, you're recognized.
They were located at the corner of the room earlier, Your Honor. Some of the representatives were there. They did not give the committee secretary their names, but they were there and now they are not here, Your Honor.
Are you referring to Attorney Zuleika Lopez?
For clarification, Your Honor, there was an error in recognition of Attorney Zuleika. The observation of Pong Akop is valid. Wala po talaga siya.
Hindi po wala talaga.
Mga security po yata kanina yung dumating, Your Honor.
Okay, security lang.
So nagkamali yung mga congressmen. Nakala nila may representative yung Office of the Vice President.
Mr. Chair.
Wala talagang dumating po.
Mr.
Totally. Inisnab ni Inday
yes,
po.
Congressman Swansing.
Mr. Chair, with regard to the letter being discussed at the moment, I also asked to confirm with Representative Luis Lo. This said letter was already requested and brought up during the second hearing for the OVP budget deliberations. And this letter was already furnished to us during that committee hearing.
So we are already in receipt of the letter?
Yes, Mr. Chair, I'll defer to Representative Luis Shaw because during the hearing itself, the representative from COA turned over that letter to Representative Luis Trow.
Yes, Congressman Luis Trow, you are recognized by the Chair.
Mr. Chair, I confirm the manifestation of the Honorable Suwan Singh that during the budget briefing of the OVP, we requested the COA the copy of the letter of the OVP opposing the subpoena duces tecum issued by the Committee on Appropriations. So may we inquire from the ComSec if we can get in touch with the Committee on APRO so we can be provided a copy of this letter opposing the subpoena. Mr. Chair.
ComSec, please take note of the manifestation of Congresswoman Luis Trow. Congressman Dan Fernandez, you're
yes,
recognized.
I just wanted to be clarified on the submission of that letter that was given to Honorable Jinky Luis Trow. Can I be informed who signed that letter?
It's certain Attorney Zuleika, Chief of Staff of the Office of the Vice President.
Chief of Staff of OVP.
Can we invite Attorney Zuleika?
ComSec? ComSec? Did we invite Attorney Zuleika?
Have we invited
him? Yes. Send an invitation? Yes.
Yes.
And
unfortunately, Attorney Zuleika Lopez is not.
How many times did we invite Attorney Zuleika?
She was invited in the September 18 hearing, Your Honor, and today as well, Your Honor.
So two times already. But we issued locations, she did not appear.
Yes, we issued, Mr. Chairman, a show cause order.
Yes, Your Honor.
There's a motion already. Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Congresswoman Luis Trow.
I just wish to manifest the three important arguments that were raised in the said letter. First is we allegedly violated the separation of power. Second, we violated the due process. And third, we violated the confidential nature of the fund, which during the briefing of the budget briefing of the Office of the Vice President, we amply addressed already, Mr. Chair.
talagang matigas yung ulo po ni Inday.
While we are waiting for the copy of that letter from the Committee on APRO, I shared the three arguments which were raised in the said letter. First is the separation of power rule. Second is the due process. And third is the confidential nature of the fund. During the budget briefing, Mr. Chair, we amply addressed already these three issues.
Okay, duly noted, Congresswoman Luistro.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, please continue your interpellation, Congressman Valeriano.
Ang problem po, yung kasunod ko sana ang tanong in regards to sa letter na ginawa ni Attorney Lopez sa OBP na or any representative from the Office of the Vice President, pero wala po sila kahit isa, Mr. Chair. So, tinatapos ko na po yung pagtatanong ko. At meron na po bang representative from the OBP?
Wala pa rin po.
Wala talaga po?
Yes,
I was informed by the registration that
dapat talaga mag-resign na si Inday po. Ayaw mag-pension, ayaw mag-trabaho po as Vice President. Hindi ni tinutupad yung kanyang mandato.
She's registration, yes. But she is not physically present.
She was here a while ago.
She was here.
Some of them were here a while ago and now they cannot be located, Your Honor.
Okay.
Wala na? Nowhere to be found, so, mga kababayan.
Terminate ko na po yung ibang katanungan ko at antayin ko na lang po sa susunod na hearing pagka dumating na po yung Office of the Vice President. Salamat po, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Ngayon, mga kababayan, pakinggan naman natin yung press con ni Chief Escudero, Senate President, tapos ni Martin Romualdez, Speaker of the House, on the LEDAC meeting with President Marcos. Kasi kailangan na pong maipasa yung mga important na legislation. At sinertify po ng ating Pangulo yung budget for 2025, yung GAA. GAB pala siya ngayon na magiging GAA once na na-approve na siya. Sinertify siya as urgent. Ngayon, siyempre, yung problem child ng Pilipinas, si Inday, hindi man mag-attend ng deliberation sa Congress, sa plenary. Ngayon, tanong po ng kasi nagpa-presscon sa Palacio Malacanang, tanong ngayon ng mainstream, ano mangyayari sa budget? Ito yung paliwanag po ni Martin Romualdez. Pakinggan po natin, mga kababayan.
Chona Yu, Mr. Speaker, speaking of budget, what will happen to the budget of the Office of the Vice President?
Sa ngayon po, we are on our last day for plenary sessions at saka inaabangan natin ng OBP. So, sa ngayon yata, hindi pa yata siya sumipot pero
hindi pa sumisipot
sa Kongreso. Actually, dapat nandun ako ngayon pero nandito tayo. Pero iniintayin din natin yung representatives o si
relax si Martin po.
Sir, what will happen pag hindi siya dumating? What will happen po pag hindi siya dumating, si Vice President?
Abangan. Ang susunod na panata sa mga sabah. Pero hindi. Sa totoo lang po, we will take this matter up shortly and you will soon be informed of its resolution po.
Thank you.
Salamat.
Ano po kaya ibang challenges na nakikita natin that can hinder yung on-time na passage ng budget?
Wala po na. Wala lang pong challenge kay this will allow us kasi we are all set and scheduled to pass this on second reading tonight, but the certification of urgency allows us to similarly pass it within short order today at the meeting. So handa-handa kami na ipasa itong gab natin for transmission to the Senate in short order. Pero mamayang gabi, tapos na to.
Tataposin pa rin, mga kababayan.
For Christmas, ma-approve na po ni Pangulo Marcos yung budget kung on time naman po yung
Opo, yun po talaga. Ang hangarin na po natin ay para meron maligayang Pasko. Hindi lang para sa pag-usa administrat, pero sa taong bayan na meron tayong isang national budget for progress, prosperity, and development para sa buong sambayan Pilipinas.
Pia Gutierrez po.
Sir, speaking of the OVP's budget, can we get your comment or reaction on the VP's decision to repeatedly snub yung plenary debates? And could this lead to any delays in the passage of the budget?
Well, we'd like to very much see the Vice President, but she is elected to absent herself and she sent us letters explaining why. But of course, we would most appreciate her presence.
Very safe mag mag ano magsagot si Martin.
Sorry again about the vice president, like she said,
kinukulit talaga si Martin po na magsalita ng controversial
budget, and as a result some members of the house are saying that if she doesn't want to fulfill her duties as vice president, they can call for her just to give up the post or just resign.
Just resign.
What are your thoughts on this, Speaker?
Well, lahat ng mga congressman may ideas, meron silang opinion. But before tonight's end, we will come to a resolution, and that will be the act of the plenary. So instead of listening to individual opinions or comments, as you know, in Congress, we act in a consensus, as a consensus body, and as a collegiate body, rather. And so we will deal with that as soon as you allow us to leave this press con, so we can return back to normal programming. But we are very, very delighted with this opportunity. Maraming salamat sa pagbibigay ng ating ulat sa magandang line dyan sa Ledac kanina po, kasama natin ang mga Presidente Presidente Marcos Jr.
Ledac-related question. The Ledac meeting this morning. Ano ho kaya ang pwede nyo ma-share sa mga sa taong bayan kung ano sa mga priority measures na ito ang top of the list? Kumbaga, priority of priorities.
Well, obviously, the number one is still the national budget. That is the matter of all legislation, where all the initiatives, programs, and how the economy will be reinvigorated or to move forward for everyone's benefit. Concomitant to that are other legislations that we have a whole gamut of them. I do not know where to begin. Kasi may 64 dito, pero I find them almost equally important, but I passed just about all, so I don't know where to begin other than the fact that I can give you the 64 priority legislations. I will maybe defer to the Senate President, because some of the senators like to say that they are more deliberate on this, so baka they have something more, well, they prioritize some of the legislation, but in our case, we have taken them as a whole. And as we've already reported, we have passed this way, way in advance of schedule, taking it as a whole bundle host. But kasi mas maraming yun tayo makaka-deliberate, kasi mas maraming tatlong daan kami. Kaya we can actually, kaya natin tutupan talaga. Pero the Senate may appear to be more deliberate in its actions, because they only have 24 senators to work on it. But we always differ, and actually in practice we usually concur with Senate versions on matters and in order of the priorities. So I think I'll defer for this moment to the Senate President on what he determines or what he feels are top priorities.
So yan po, kain na lang po tayo. Ah. Mapapakain ka talaga sa ano, sa sarap. That's our short video, mga kababayan. Habang kumakain po tayo, nakikinig tayo sa ano? Nakikinig tayo sa hearing ng Congress kung paano winaldas yung pondo ng bayan ng ano, ng lorong pusit. Bye-bye po muna.